Welcome to Election Day. My name is Nico Vangeli. I'm the Assistant City Clerk and one of the chief election officials for the city. Today I'm going to walk you through the voting process.
Good afternoon. Welcome to precincts 91, 92, 93.
So Mr. Walker, he's the warden at 93, and he's taking a few minutes from his day today to assist some of the voters. Temple Emmanuel, also known as the May Street building at 280 May Street, is a triple precinct. It's one of our largest precincts in the city. And when voters get to this precinct, they have questions about which polling location to vote in. So we're using the iPad technology we purchased last year to assist voters who find their precinct. So whenever a first-time voter approaches the precinct, or any voter who hasn't voted in the precinct for a while, and they don't know which location to go into, they approach Mr. Walker, and Mr. Walker will locate them by their last name and first name or street address. Once they provide that information to Mr. Walker, then Mr. Walker will direct them to the correct precinct, whether it's 91, 92, or 93. We started implementing this new technology in November of 2016, and we would like to continue to do that moving forward in every single election. We find it in the larger precincts, it's easier for voters who don't know their warden precinct to approach somebody like Mr. Walker and find out where they're supposed to go on election day. We also use this tool as the voter lookup if a voter shows up to the wrong precinct. So for example, if a voter shows up at 91, but they're really registered at 61, we will use this technology to direct the voter to the proper precinct. When you approach a polling location, you'll first be greeted by the check-in inspectors. You'll state first your address, then your name, and from there the poll worker will locate you on the voter list. Once you're located on the voter list, another poll worker will hand you a ballot, and then you'll make your way to the voting booth. You have two options to use in terms of marking your ballot. You can use the voting booth, or you can use the AutoMark machine. The AutoMark machine acts like a pen. It will assist you with marking the ballot. The AutoMark machine is available for any voter throughout the 50 precincts. The AutoMark machine is there to assist you if you have any trouble reading the ballot. It will magnify the size of the ballot. It will also provide some contrast if you need some contrast on the ballot. It will also read you the ballot.
This is the summary screen. Use the up and down arrow keys to scroll through each contest.
You can ask the check-in inspector or the warden where the AutoMark is located. If you need any assistance of how to use the AutoMark, the warden or the poll worker is there to assist you. Once you mark your ballot, now you can approach the checkout table. At the checkout table, the poll worker will once again ask for your address, your name. The poll worker will locate your address and name on the voting list. They will use a red pencil to mark a check. Once they've checked you out, then you move from the checkout table to the voting machine. You will insert the ballot inside the voting machine, and the machine will tabulate your vote.
Have a nice day.
You too.
And now you have completed your voting process. If for some reason you're listed inactive on the voting list, the check-in inspector will guide you from the check-in table to the warden table, where the warden or the clerk will assist you with an inactive voting process. Again, do not panic. You're still eligible to vote in this election. And today we have Colin Novick, and he's going to explain to you what lowercase I or inactive is.
When a voter approaches the table being inactive, we take this form, and in about a minute and a half, we have them on their way and ready to vote. It's quite simple. We have them write their address, how long they've been living there, their name, any former address, then they sign their name, the date, print, their date of birth. The last piece is they need a piece of documentation that has their name and their address on it. And that can be anything from a bill to a form of government ID. And they're on their way and ready to vote.
It does give you the instructions on how many people you can vote for. Just don't vote more than what's required, and that way all your votes will be counted. For at large, there are 8 candidates. You only have to select 6, no more than 6, but you can select less than 6. It's your choice. The same thing with the school committee. There's a majority, and you can pick less, but no more than that. If someone overvotes, let's say it's at large, someone overvotes at the at large, they can't count the rest of all those votes. But if you did it right for district council and you did it right for school committee, those votes will count. Just be careful. Read the instructions, and it might look a little small. And if you need assistance, there's poll workers there to remind you if you're not clear.